from Lego Buff Productions, here with another episode of Laugh, Lego Answers and Facts. Now this week's theme was Lego YouTube channels. Now before we get into those questions, next week's theme is kind of a sub-theme of an earlier theme, which was mocks, and next week's theme will be landscaping. So any questions about landscaping mocks or just landscaping with Lego in general, you can go ahead and put those questions in the comments below. So moving on to this week's questions. Eden Hailstone asked, what someone inspired, I think he's trying to ask, who inspired you to make Lego videos? Now, most of you know who Solid Brick Studios is, and that's one of the main reasons I started. I did watch a ton of other Lego YouTubers, but he was really the main one that I kept going back to, and this was about 4 years ago, I want to say, but I made a YouTube channel, I think in 2012. I didn't really start posting videos to 2013. And then I went from there. I think it was 2012. Maybe it was 2013 that I made my channel. I'm not sure. But I was into YouTube way before that. I just watched the videos, but I didn't know about subscribing and stuff. I didn't know how all of that really worked out. So he's my main one. But like, I've been inspired by Brickfilmers and a ton of other YouTubers. So not just David. Sean Double J asked, do you promote your channel at all using social media or forums? If so, which ones do you use? Now, before, that definitely was a no. But recently, I have gotten a Flickr, although I don't really use it a lot. But I do have an Instagram, and that's what I use a ton to promote my channel, I guess you could say. So I don't really use any forms, just Instagram to promote my channel. Kangaroo Joe asked, I recently started posting Lego stuff on my channel, but how can I get it advertised out so people will view it? That's a tough question. It's not really a good idea to post on other people's videos, oh, check out this video, because usually it gets marked as spam, first of all, so no one will even see it. And it's just kind of not really respected on YouTube. People like look down on those type of people. So, I mean, if you do it now, you can definitely stop and change it. But the best way is just to produce good content and keep making more videos. That's the key, really. If you keep making videos, you will eventually gain subscribers. That's how I made it this far. Rand Corfett asked, who inspired you to do YouTube? Again, Solid Brick Studios and a few other people did that. And then, what is your favorite YouTube channel? Now, that's a tough question because there's a lot of really good ones out there. One that I just found recently is actually called JK Brickworks, and it's this guy, and he's by far like the best builder I've ever seen. He has some really awesome stuff. Definitely want to check out his channel if you have not already. But I really like Jang Bricks. His city is really awesome. And then, of course, there's the mock builders. You have TWC, Chris Productions. There's a few others. Lego Spencer, you know. Those sort of people. So I watch a wide variety of different YouTubers. Lego YouTubers. The Anything Reviewer asks, what camera is good reviewing camera? Now, this is the camera I use for my updates. And this is the one I used to use for reviews in all my videos. I use this camera, but I do have a new one which I'm filming on now, and that's a Sony. I'm not sure the name of it, but it's a larger camera. You can see it in my updates. I think two updates ago I showed the camera. It's also on my Instagram, so if you follow me on Instagram, you'll see the picture with that. But this is called the Canon Vixia HF M301. I know they don't sell it anymore, but they sell ones very similar to this camera. It's just a basic camera. It films HD, but it worked out really nicely for me. But I definitely wanted to upgrade to something a little more professional. I'm still getting used to the new camera, but definitely a lot better than this one. But again, if you're just starting off, this is perfectly fine. Or even like a digital camera, or iPhones and other phones are really starting to get good with their quality. MegaPanzer13 asked, how did you gain a lot of subscribers and what inspired you to start a YouTube channel? Again, I already talked about the inspiration thing. Also Pizza Movies, I forgot to mention him. He really, when I started, I wanted to do brick films. Before I actually made my YouTube channel, I made like 10 brick films or something. They're not on YouTube, they're awful. But after I saw Pizza Movies, I just really started brick filming then, and that's really what got me into making videos and combining that with Lego. Now, to answer the first part, how do you gain a lot of subscribers? That's a tough question. And I'm just going to go into that right now because a lot of other people asked about, like, how do you get famous? How do you grow your channel and that sort of thing? So, my advice for this is there's a couple of things. First of all, if you're going to do something, you got to do it right. You got to do it the best you can possibly can. So, if you're going to do a review, let's say you want to review this Corporate Alliance Tank Droid, don't just I mean, unless you really wanted to, but don't just, like, stand here and be like, here's my Lego set. Look at it spins. Like, these are the features. Look, it has flickfire missiles, you know, but they don't work. And that, and then, like look at here. This is what it looks like. You know, I mean, that's just really not a good review style. And you're not really going to get views because it's not the best. You can definitely do way better than that. You can set up a white background if you want to do that. But I'm not saying you have to do that. That's just what I do, but and some other people do. But whatever you prefer, like if you want to have a wall as your background or maybe some other Lego sets where you focus the camera nicely so it kind of gives a nice backdrop. You don't want something like this. And I mean, it's kind of sloppy. So you want to do it the best way you possibly can and put real effort into it. You don't want to just be like, oh, I'll just make videos and I'll be famous, you know, like upload a video of a tutorial like how to make a tree and you just show this like or you just show a Lego set and be like, oh, this is a tutorial, you know, of how to make that. Now you'll actually really want to put as much work into it as possible, and what can I tell you, your work definitely pays off. And then again, advertising on social media is fine, but don't post comments on other people's channels. And when I started, I did not advertise at all anywhere. I just constantly posted videos to grow my audience, and I posted good content. That's the other thing. You want to be original. Don't post like the same exact videos everyone else is doing. Try to make your own series or something like that. Like I'm doing Laugh right now. I mean, some other people do the Q&As like that. And then I did the minifigs up close, even though that's over. I do mock building 101. I did brick filming 101. And you can do generic videos like hauls and stuff. That's fine. But what's really going to draw viewers to your channel is unique videos. Now, let's see, on to Will Rains. Yes, what is your favorite LEGO YouTube channel? Again, I have a wide variety of that. Epic Bricks asks, favorite YouTube channel? Answer that. How do you be successful on your channel? Answer that. And can you check out my channel? Now, that's a question I do get a lot from people, more so now than before. And I might end up checking out your channel. Before, I'd always go check out your channel, but I've been really busy with school. I'm in high school, if some of you don't know. I'm a sophomore, and I've been really busy with school. Really busy. It's hard to post a lot of videos. I know I've been slacking the past couple weeks or so. I'll talk about that in my update. And then just, I watch a ton of other YouTube videos, but I don't always have time to check out everyone's channel. So if I don't check out your channel, I'm sorry. But if you keep posting, like, check out my channel, check out my channel, check out my video, I probably won't, but I might end up checking yours if you just post once. Or if you're a constant viewer, sometimes I do that, even if you don't ask. Be like, oh, this person comments on most of my videos, or comments on every weekly update I post. Oh, I'll check out their channel, you know. It's worth it. And then I might end up subscribing. I've definitely done that a couple of times now. Minecraft / Minecraft Man asked, what made you want to start making YouTube videos again? Starbucks Studios, Pizza Movies. There's a few other people I watched. James Wilson, what camera did you start with your videos again? It's Canon. And then the one I'm showing, or the one I'm filming with now, again, it's on Instagram, so if you want to check that out, more info is there. Let's see. Brick Pop Productions, what are good standard cameras to use? I currently have a Samsung camera, not sure of the specs. Is it worth buying a high-tech Canon camera? Now, that's another good question. Again, this one's Canon. I prefer Canon, even though this camera right now is Sony, because the Canon version of this is way, way too expensive, and this is the same thing, basically, so why would I pay way more when I can get the same quality as Sony? And Sony's a good brand too. Canon's probably one of the best brands, but Sony is good too, and Panasonic's good. So if you have any camcorder that looks like this that films in HD, that's perfectly fine. All right, moving on. We have Kyle Prinke. Oh, wait, it's pronounced Princiotti. Not sure if that's how you say it, but put it there, so sorry if I butchered that last name. But anyway, is it difficult to make videos almost daily like YouTube? Yes, very difficult, especially with school. Like I said, the last week and a half, or 2 weeks and weeks before that, I've really been struggling with that. I try to post Saturday, Sunday, and then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I was planning to post Fridays, but I just haven't been doing that. And then last week, I only posted a haul besides my weekly update. So next year, though, again, this is all coming my weekly update, so check that video out if you want to know more about this information. But next year, I have a huge, huge, massive plan that is going to be epic. And it's by far the best thing I've ever thought of. And I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. So I've been working really hard to put that plan into motion. So again, more info in my weekly update on that. Nick Productions asks, what's the best way to gain subscribers for your YouTube channel? What are some helpful YouTube channel growing tips? Again, just constant videos, put quality in videos, and also you want to make some good thumbnails. There's plenty of free editing software you can get. I know some people are like, oh, you have to have Photoshop to make good thumbnails. I don't have Photoshop. Well, technically, I have Photoshop, but I don't use it. I use Roxio Photo Editor, Roxio Photo Suite. I'm not sure. I don't think that's free, but I just had it on the computer that I got. But there's plenty of other free software you can find on the internet that you can use that just works perfectly. So you want to put time in your thumbnails. Don't just... You always want to make your thumbnail. That's my key. I've never used just the... Even when I started, I never used just whatever it showed up as. I always made my own thumbnail. I think that's the real key. Making your own thumbnails because it shows your creativity there. And again, just putting the effort into your videos. That's the real key. Tyrannosaurus Gamer 57, how do you become successful? Again, answer that. Star Wars Guy, what is the most subbed Lego YouTube channel? That's a great question. I'm pretty sure it's Mad About Lego. I'm not sure. It's between Mad About Lego, Brick Show, and Jeng Bricks. I know they're all over 200,000. Not sure if they're any higher than that. But some of you might say, oh, EvanTubeHD, you know, he has over 500,000. But I personally do not consider him a Lego YouTuber. But your opinion might be different. Alright, last few questions. XX Minecraft for the win. How do you edit your Lego videos? I use a software called Pinnacle Studio. I have 17 now. Well, I have 15, and I just got 17 about a month or so ago. So I'm slowly transitioning to the 17. Again, like, I'm slowly transitioning from this camera to that one. But next year, I'm working on all the kinks and stuff. So next year, I will be all in on the camera and the new editing software. Lego Ace Productions asks, how do you make your intros? That's in the editing software. It's this feature called Montage Themes. But I will have a new intro for next year, and it's not going to be one of those. It's going to be a lot shorter, and I'm really proud of it. It's really awesome. And he also asked, what's a good camera to use for mocks and updates? Again, for updates, I recommend using... I still use this for my updates. I probably always will, because that camera is like this big, and it's hard to move around and stuff. So this is just easy. You know, I just film like this, you know, like, oh, look at this. I can pick up stuff where that camera, I have to have like two hands on it and stuff, and it's hefty and stuff. So definitely a smaller camera would be good. For mocks, you want to use your best quality camera, because those are going to be your most watched videos, most likely. Daniel Kislev asked, do you like any stop motion animators such as Forest Fire 101, Brotherhood Workshop, etc.? Yes, I love Brick Films. I'm really looking forward to do a bunch more of those in the future. I know I don't really have any on my channel right now, and unfortunately I had to cancel that one, but I have some big plans for next year. Again, nothing like the project I had planned for this year that we're in right now, 2014, because that was just unrealistic. But I really thought through this plan that I have for next year. So again, I hope you guys really like that. But yeah, I love Brick Films. I love Forest Fire 101, Brotherhood Workshop. Keshinate's another good one. There's plenty of good Brick Filmers out there. And a lot of them are like no-name ones, which I'm kind of surprised. Like, I've never heard their channels. Like, I'm finding a bunch more now as I go on. But I just love Brick Films. They're really awesome. And then Lego Brick Review Productions asked, how do you start a successful YouTube Lego account? Are there any certain things needed? Again, as I've been saying before, just put time and effort into your work. So that does it for this video. Again, don't forget to ask any questions about landscaping with Lego for next week. So thanks for watching, and have a great day.